is to see that what actually is the electric field seen by individual ion or molecule or atom in the dielectric field. Is it the field that we apply is only the field it will show, or it will feel, or it will be in affected, or do you find any extra fields that are there acting on the dipole in the dielectric material? Therefore, we will now look at what is an internal field in a dielectric material and how this internal field acts or affects the dielectric material. To see this, we will now go and start today's class to learn what is an internal field in solids or dielectric materials, and also we'll look at finally derive an equation called Clausius-Mossotti's equation. First, we will understand the concept of internal field. To understand the concept of internal field, here I'll draw a diagram of a parallel plate capacitor. This is the one plate, this is the another plate, and we apply some voltage to this. And suppose I am taking a voltage and adding a positive terminal and a negative terminal connected to this. And you know that this is a positive and this is the negative, and we have applied a voltage V. In such cases, the charges that are there on the plates, you can write them as positive charges on one of the plates and negative charges on other plates. So we have a positive charge here, and the positive charge is accumulated on the plate, and the positive charge will be accumulated on this plate. And we can see a negative charge equal number is induced on the other side. So this will create a field between the two plates, that is the plate. And I call this is the E0 is the electric field created between the plates from positive plate to negative plate when there is no dielectric is placed. Now we'll keep a dielectric material in it. So the dielectric material is an insulator having a property of induced charges when placed in an electric field. So I am taking here, this is the dielectric material. So this is the dielectric. If I take this dielectric material, and you know that dielectric material will have a property of induced charges. So here opposite charges, negative charges are induced, and here we have positive charges induced. And thereby there is an electric field due to these induced charges. And I may be calling this induced charge maybe something like EDED, that is called depolarization field because of polarized charges. This is the field. Therefore, net field acting on the dielectric place in electric field is because of the applied field E and also induced charges. But if you look at any one of the atom inside the dielectric, what is actual field? I have to see it. To find out, I choose a single atom or a group of atoms in a small area in the dielectric. Thereby, I just to find out what must be the field that is acting in the on the each of the atom or the molecule or the ion, I just make a hole in the dielectric. I remove this part, scoop it up out, and I'll get that part something like this. So if I remove this part in the dielectric, then what happens is that there is a cavity formed in the dielectric. So this is the cavity that is formed in the dielectric. This is the cavity. So once a cavity is formed, then immediately positive charges will appear here close to the negative charges, and negative charges will be appearing on the surface of the cavity. But inside also there is a field. Inside also will have negative charges and positive charges. Therefore, the field due to this cavity surface charges induced on the surface also acts any atom that is placed inside the cavity, inside this cavity. When you place the cavity inside it, okay, then I will take from this one atom or one molecule. And what is the field acting on this? The field will be acting on this is due to the applied field, E due to the charges that are induced on the surface, E due to the charges that are there in the cavity, and in the cavity there are some more atoms also. And these atoms will also have atomic dipoles and they create a field. And this field created by the atoms on a test charge will also be there, and therefore the net field that is seen by the atom or a molecule or a electric dipole will be not that simply applied field. So what are the fields that are applying? These are the fields that are applying. Look at this. This is the external field I am applying. So positive charges on the first plate and negative charges on the second plate. And the charge direction of the electric field is from positive to negative. This is the applied external field. This is the one field, first field. The second field is that when the positive and negative charges are there on the dielectric, we have positive charges on the negative plate side and negative charges on the positive plate side. And the field is in opposite direction. That is called depolarizing field, EP. But now, to know what actually is the field on an atom, to see, I'll remove a group of atoms or I scoop it, I make a hole and I take that hole. And this is the hole. Because of making a hole, the surface charges are induced at the positive sides of the charges, induced charges on dielectric, I'll get negative charges on the surface of the cavity and positive charges on the negative side of the cavity. Therefore, this field also acts on the atom which is there at the center. Okay? So, not only this, if I now look at this small part which I have taken, I look at the unit cell. Therefore, initially, if I remove a small part of the dielectric material, which I created a cavity, and I'll see that this cavity is having negative and positive induced charges. These negative positive induced charges on the outer surface of the cavity will give you a field, and it is called Lorentz force or on the surface of the cavity. And then if I take one of the atom inside that is called this one. So I have this, the field, what is the field on this particular atom? So I have to take the surrounding atoms or surrounding dipoles. This is the dipole and this is the dipole. Because I have taken a part of it, there are many dipoles in this. These dipoles will try act and give rise to some field on this particular atom. And that field we call it as, the near field or local field. This is called local field. Therefore, the local field acting on a particular atom inside a dielectric material is not just only the external field that is there because of applied voltage. That is not only this. We have this plus the depolarizing field because of the ions that are induced when the electric is placed between the plates of a capacitor. And to know what is the field on each ion, I have removed some of the portion of it which called a spherical cavity. In the spherical cavity we have Lorentz force, and that is called Lorentz field, and then we have local field. So the local field is sum of all these fields. Not that, but this opposite direction you have to see it. Okay, not only the external field we apply it. Therefore, it is very complex to calculate this, and this can be calculated based on various assumptions. we are not going to see all those assumptions. We will go for a simple derivation. You can have a cavity, spherical cavity, cylindrical cavity, and therefore, depending on the shape of the cavity, you are creating the fields also changes. You can have a cavity something like this, as a spherical cavity, or a cylindrical rod cavity, something like this. Okay, thereby these cavities will give rise to different Lorentz forces. But anyway, we do a simple analysis of internal fields by supposing this. Now you remember that the total field acting on an atom is called local field. Local field is because of the external applied voltage, depolarizing field because of induced charges on the surface of the dielectric, and the Lorentz force or Lorentz field due to the charges that are created on the outer surface of the cavity, and also we have local dipoles nearby for a test one, and all these put together will give you the local field, and that is called the internal field. Now we look at the internal field. See, we have ELOC, local field, and this local field is not only because of E, but it is also because of various polarizations that are taking surrounding the medium or the dipole. And while we are looking at, we have macroscopic scale and we also have microscopic scale. But on a macroscopic level, the material overall field is zero because of electrical neutrality. But if you go for atom-wise, molecule-wise, or ion-wise, it is individual atoms, then this is not the case. What happens is there will be a field on each of the atom or each of the molecule. Therefore, local field is sum of the applied field for other field that what we have seen in the earlier slide. So these fields, okay, we have shown in a figure. So now we will look at the microscopic fields. What are the microscopic fields? There are two macroscopic fields. Macroscopic means large field. One is the applied field is the large field, and on the whole of the bulk of the dielectric medium. Therefore, we are calling it as a macroscopic field. Macro means large, and taking dielectric as a bulk material. And a depolarizing field. The depolarizing field is due to the polarization effect of dielectric, which induces surface charges. And we have two microscopic fields. And two microscopic fields is easy. The field at the cavity due to the charges that are surrounding it. Then second is the Lorentz field at the center of the spherical cavity due to the charges inside the spherical cavity. So therefore, in a dielectric material, an atom will be induced or will be acted upon by two macroscopic fields and two microscopic fields. So these macroscopic and microscopic fields, we have already seen this. To get an expression for this, we have to now look at various fields. One, the local field is equal to the applied field E0, depolarization field, surface field, and dipole field. And all those are shown here. External field, depolarization field, okay, surface field or Lorentz field, and dipole field. Four fields are there. Two, find it out, I consider a dielectric material placed between plates of a dielectric material of parallel plates, and then I suppose that I just remove a circular cavity or a small scoop from the dielectric material. But I take that this radius is not too large or not too small. If I take too small, then it may not be at least include one or two molecules. Therefore, when you take a circular cavity or a spherical cavity, the radius of the cavity should be large compared to intermolecular distance. Otherwise, it will not include one at least a molecule. Therefore, there are no dipoles. But it must be very, very small than the dimensions of the electric field. If you take large cavity, then the field acting and the number of atoms you are removed is very large. Therefore, calculation is not correct. Hence, to do that, the first important is that you have to keep the dielectric, remove a circular or make a circular cavity whose radius r is such that it is large compared to intermolecular distance, but it is less than the dimension of the dielectric material. And these are the four fields that are created. So I am writing all the four forces: E local, E naught, applied force, applied field, and this is given by sigma by epsilon naught, where sigma is the surface charge density by epsilon naught. We'll get it as. And E depolarizing field is due to polarized charges on the outer surface, which is given by minus P by epsilon naught. Because the polarization gives you polarization vector P, that is electric dipole moment per unit volume, that is P by epsilon naught. And E surface is the field due to the polarized charges on the surface, inner surface of the spherical cavity, produced at the center of the cavity, that is minus P by 3 epsilon naught. And dipole field is the field inside. If you take a test cavity, a test dipole, or what is the field that is acting by the surrounding dipoles on the test dipole is called this. But generally, this can be taken zero for cubic lattices. Thereby, I write E local is equal to E0. I should put here E naught. Okay, naught is there. You have to keep here E naught plus E surface. Okay, so sorry, I'm just rewriting this equation. Where is it? Okay, so E plus surface plus dip. That means this E is now the summation of E naught and depolarization. The applied field, we know you can measure it, how much is there. And E surface inside it is how much is there, E dip is there. So therefore, E local can be written as E plus surface plus E dip. But E dipole can be made zero if you are taking it as cubic lattice. Thereby, you can write by taking a cubic lattice without loss of generality, I write this as E plus E surface. So we are simplifying our analysis to derive an expression for internal field. So then I take that internal field. To understand internal field, I am taking here one atom. And this atom will be, suppose, say, polar, or maybe when placed, it is the center of gravity of positive charge and negative charges are get separated. This may be a positive charge and this may be a negative charge. And it will be a dipole. And this atom, I'm taking one of the atom I'm taking, and if I take this one of the atom, this is the distance between positive and a negative charge, which is equal to the dipole length d. And when dipole length d is there, the dipole moment mu is equal to charge into d. That means q is there, qd is the dipole moment. This is for one atom. But now I want to calculate the internal field due to a dielectric placed inside the parallel plates. Therefore, I have lot number of atoms in three dimensions. Again, for simplicity, I'll take one dimension only along a line. Okay, I'll consider some of the atoms. This is the line. Along this one dimension, I will consider some atoms. This is another atom close to this. This is another atom. This is another atom. All the atoms are regularly spaced. I take two more atoms here. Okay, they are touching each other. Here, see this. And I have enlarged this figure much. Now, I consider this as one dipole. Okay, here we have one dipole, second dipole, third dipole, fourth dipole, and so on and so forth. There are many dipoles. And this is maybe n minus one dipole, or nth dipole, or ith dipole. Maybe it is ith dipole. So we have many dipoles. And within the cavity, when you remove a small part of it, and in that part I have taken line of atoms here. Now I choose here a test atom at a point here. This is the test atom, okay, at point A. on this test atom, what is this? The test atom for us, or test dipole for us. Okay, on this test dipole, what is the field that is due to this atom, this atom, this atom, this atom, or this, or this? To calculate the field on this atom A, or on this dipole A at point A, I first initially calculate a general equation by taking that the field created, or the field experienced by atom A due to the first atom at a distance, maybe n A distance. So to understand this, I am now showing you something like this. Dipole moment is alpha into E local. You know that we have seen that the dipole moment is proportional to applied field E, but here it is not that only applied field acting, the other field acting, the total field acting is called E local field, which is a sum of applied field, depolarization field, Lorentz field, and dipole field. Therefore, total field I have to take it. Therefore, mu I dipole moment is equal to alpha into local. And I want to calculate the electric field on the atomic dipole at a point A due to induced dipole at a distance n A. Either this side or this side, I take N. Some atom at a distance. So what is that atom I am taking, considering in this, is suppose say this is the A is the distance between two positive charges. Now I am taking here a test, this is the test atom. Now I want to calculate what is the field due to this particular atom on this atom. I want to calculate it, which is, I'm supposing it is NA distance away from the test atom A. Okay, A is this, you know it. N is maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, anything. So 1, 2, 3, 4 atoms, if I take it as. Now, to calculate this, I am now writing the E surface energy. You know that the electric force F is equal to Q1, Q2 by R square into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Otherwise, the Coulomb force, you'll write F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q2 by R square. If the two charges are there with this force, we know that the electric field due to this charge is simply 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So it is not the force here. Remember, it is an electric field that we are calculating because of this atom on this. So thereby, I write here that the surface 1 is equal to charge ZE Q, okay, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R, 1 by R square. 1 by R square is that from this atom is at a distance of NA. Therefore, I'm writing 1 by NA square. But this is the dipole. So from this part, I have D also. Therefore, NA plus D is actual distance. That's why NA plus D I'm taking. So therefore, the distance from this atom to the test atom, A is 1 by NA square minus 1 by NA plus D whole square. This is the charge. It is very simply that the electric field E due to a charge at a point is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, you know already this, okay, Q by R square, epsilon naught, Q by R square. Here Q is the atom, atom will have an atomic number Z, and therefore ZE is the charge. This Q is ZE. And R I am calculating from the figure as this. So I just rearrange by taking LCM. If I take LCM, I will get this equation. From this equation, if I expand this term and this term, expansion, I will get the next step as ZE is equal to simply ZE by 4 pi epsilon naught. This NA square will cancel. I have D square as it is. I have 2NAD. And this whatever there, I am writing as it is here. So remember this equation, we'll go to the next slide with that equation. So This equation, I'm supposing Na is much, much greater than D because dipole distance is this. In the atom, I'm taking dipole distance as this, which is small, where I have a large number of atoms here. Therefore, this distance is much larger than this distance. Hence, I'm approximately taking Na plus D as Na. If this substitution, I'll get this term as it is here, okay? And this is, I'm taking D common. If I take D common, I'll get 2Na plus D by 2, which is very, very small. Therefore, that can be taken as 2NaD. And this I am replacing Na plus D as Na. Therefore, I'll get Na square is already there. This is approximated as Na square. Therefore, I'll get this expression changed to Ze by 4 pi epsilon naught 2NaD. This I have 1Na gets cancels. I have here, okay, square is 1Na is cancelling. Therefore, 1 is left here. Therefore, I'll have Na cube. So 2D Na cube. And this I'll just simplify it and rewrite it as I'm taking 2 cancelling in this. I'll get 2 epsilon naught. And then we have Ze into D. I'm writing it as Ze. So you look at this, Ze is the charge, D is the distance. Therefore, we have mu is equal to charge into distance. Here, charge is Ze and D is the distance or length of the dipole. So thereby, Ze D is nothing but mu. So dipole moment mu, 4 pi epsilon naught into the same. So I'm taking this equation to the next and I want to right now, E local we have written earlier is E plus E surface. You got now the surface value. So therefore, I am now adding E here and E surface is this. But see, I have slightly changed. This term as it is, I have written here, mu by 2 epsilon naught. But I have taken sigma here. Instead of taking only one atom here, we have calculated what they affected. But we have another atoms also. Each atom will give you the same field. This is from the right or from the left also, we have another field. So these will also act on this and these will act on this. Therefore, I have to take summation of all the atoms, both sides of the test charge A. This is the test charge A. Therefore, I'm taking 2 here. So here there is no 2, I'm taking 2 because I'm taking either sides. The fields created by each of the dipole away from the test charge is same. Therefore, I'm taking. As I'm taking many atoms are there on either side, I'm taking sigma n equal to 1 to total n. That means n equal to, I write 1 to capital N. That is the sigma. All atoms I'm taking it. So if I substitute this, simplify it, I'll get E as it is, 2, this term as it is, and 2 also as it is. As A is a constant distance between two positive charges, I'm writing this as like this. And therefore, I left it sigma 1 by n cube. Sigma 1 by n cube is nothing but 1.2. Because if I take 1 by sigma 1 plus 1, 1 by n cube 8, and so on, I'll get it as. So I'm approximately taking this as 1.2. So therefore, this 2 and this 2 can be now cancelled. I'll get E is equal to this. Thereby, E local is equal to E plus 1.2, 4 pi epsilon naught A cube. So I will now write it as 1.2 pi as a constant as this, because we know that P is equal to Ne or Nu. So therefore, I have E here. Okay, N cube. Cube is the distance, that is the value distance between the two positive charges. So mu I is the dipole moment. Dipole moment per unit volume is P. Therefore, N I am taking it as. Therefore, I am taking rest of all of them into constant gamma. I am writing this as P and P by epsilon naught I am writing it as. So thereby, you can write now this equation as for cubic lattice, it was found that gamma is 1 by 3. So gamma is 1 by 3. Therefore, E local will become E plus P by 3 epsilon naught. And we are deriving it for a cubic system. and it may be changing. So we have equation P equal to N alpha E. And now E should be not only applied voltage, it should be replaced by local field, all local fields. Thereby, alpha from this equation I am writing as is alpha is NE by local. If I take these two other side, I'll P by this I'll get. This is the alpha. But we have seen local field is derived as E plus P by 3 epsilon naught. Now you substitute U local in this expression. If I substitute, I'll get alpha is equal to P by N. This is E local is this now. So if I substitute E local there, we have another equation in the beginning, basics of the parameters of dielectric materials, we have this equation. And I am now writing P, this P, okay? So we have now this equation. If I write E from this, okay? I am writing this as P N, and E is now P by, if I take all of this, the other side, I will get as E is equal to P by this, P by epsilon naught this. I'm getting like this. And this is as it is. So therefore, if I cancel P, P, P whole, I'll get alpha is equal to epsilon naught. I'm taking the LCM going out and I'll get it is 1 by epsilon r minus 1 by 3. Now I am writing this as N, I'm taking this side and I'm taking epsilon the other side. Therefore, I'll get N alpha by epsilon is equal to this. If I take LCM, I will get N alpha is equal to this. After taking, because it is 3R minus 3 plus 1, so epsilon R plus 2 by 3R plus. If I just rearrange it, I can write it as by alpha by epsilon, it is equal to 3 epsilon R minus epsilon plus 2. This I am taking the equation, I'm changing this into 3 taking the other side. So we'll get this. And this equation is called Clausius-Mosotis equation. We have a lot of applications. Okay. Now, but we know that dielectric constant, that is epsilon naught is equal to N square, where N is refractive index. That means refractive index of the material is directly linked to dielectric constant. So thereby, you can write here that N alpha is equal to, if I keep it as N square here and here, I'll get this equation. And if I put the known equation, because you know epsilon is equal to epsilon or epsilon naught, I'm using this, I'm keeping in this. And this is called specific polarization. This is called specific polarization. And this derivation is one of the important question and also important to understand behavior of dielectrics in external field. Now we look at this. So I'm doing some problems. Hello. So some problems from the previous chapter. So we'll do some problems. Read this problem first. So the problem is that a diamagnetic material Al2O3 is placed in a magnetic field of this. Evaluate magnetization M. They're asking to find what is M, magnetic flux B of this. But they have given the value of the susceptibility. So to solve this, I'm using chi equal to M by H or MA is equal to chi H. Chi they have given negative sign. A negative sign means that it's a diamagnetic material and it is there. And I'm using the value of 10 to the power 5 here. I'll get the value as this. Magnetization and H will have same units. And to calculate the magnetic field flux, we have B equal to this. I'm substituting the values mu naught as 12.57 10 to the power minus 7 Henry per meter and this. Before 10 to the power 5, only just minus 5 is very small. You can neglect it. and you can calculate the field as 0.1256 Weber per meter square. And we do the next problem as calculate electronic polarizability of argon atom. And they have given the relative permittivity is there at standard temperature and pressure with the number of atoms per volume is this. So we have a formula that alpha is P is equal to Ne alpha. From this, you can derive this formula as we have seen in the earlier class. Alpha E is equal to epsilon naught epsilon R minus 1 by N. This is from dielectric materials. So epsilon naught is this. Epsilon R is given is like this, minus 1. N is the number of atoms they have given. You substitute here and simplify it. You will get alpha E value, that is electronic polarizability. So electronic polarizability is proportional to the dielectric constant. And the next problem is the number of atoms in the volume of a cube meter of a hydrogen gas is this. The radius of atom is given, calculate the polarizability. We have seen that the polarizability is proportional to cube root of atomic radius. So cube of atomic radius, is cube of atomic radius. This is the expression we have derived for electronic polarization. As we have taken hydrogen atom, in the hydrogen atom, electrons get polarized. And if I substitute the values, I'll get the value of electronic polarization as this. And I'm taking a paramagnetic material of this many atoms, and susceptibility at 350 K is this. And susceptibility value is given by like this, calculate at 1. That means they have given two temperatures how to calculate it. So we have seen in the earlier class that paramagnetic use this rock C by T, whereas the other ferromagnetic materials uses different law, which is called Curie-Weiss law, C by C minus TC. So if I take two different temperatures, I'll write C by T. That means this T into is a constant. It is less like PV is equal to NRT is equal to constant P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So therefore, I'm using a similar method of chi1 T1, okay, is equal to chi2 T2. So if I substitute T1 as 350 given value and T2 is 300, and I should know what is the value of chi2. So this is the value of chi2. And the next problem is that so this is the electric field applied, and this induces a displacement of separation of the charges as 10 to the power minus 6 meters and 1 micrometer between the electron cloud and the nucleus. What is the electronic polarization, okay, of the material? So you know that dipole moment is charge into displacement. And a charge is given as now ZE and displacement is X, which must be equal to alpha E, because you know mu is proportional to E and mu is equal to alpha E. Mu is equal to alpha E. So I am using this equation here to calculate this, and Z, whatever the number you have given, that you have to substitute. Electron charge, you know it. Displacement, they have given this. You keep it like this. So this is equal to, okay, this is equal to alpha E. So I'm equating it to alpha E. But alpha E as this, this is the E value. I'm substituting E value in this. Thereby alpha E is this, which says that alpha E is a function of Z. If given hydrogen atom, keep 1. If another atom, Z is equal to 40, keep Z is equal to 40. You will get alpha E value. Okay. So I stop here. Anyone having some doubts, they can